So here now we'll discuss about the uses of line. Fine. So here first of all we are writing here, that is uses of land. So here first very important point here is the forest, that large part of land is covered with forest. Okay, second very important one is the land not used for agriculture. Okay, land not used for agriculture. So what are the land which is not used for agriculture? So basically the first one is barren land, or apart from barren land you can also say that wasteland, hai na, where fertility is zero. Okay, you cannot use it for the agriculture, because for doing agriculture you need fertile land. Now the second one is, this one is clear. Now the second one you can include, that is the first one is barren land you have said, or the wasteland. Apart from that, land which is used for non-agriculture, such as building. Suppose on the land if you have constructed building, so how you will use for agriculture or the cultivation? Building, roads or transportation. Etc. Here I am writing etc. Fine, till here picture is clear. Now the third very important one is other uncultivated land. Okay, other uncultivated land, we will write here other uncultivated land. Other uncultivated land. You should make one very solid notes. Hai na? Making notes is very very important. Other uncultivated land. So what will come under the other uncultivated land? So here you can include permanent, okay, permanent pasture and grazing land. Permanent pasture and grazing land. Okay, permanent pasture and grazing land. Fine, permanent pasture and grazing land. Now the second one you can include, that is permanent pasture and grazing land is over. Now apart from permanent pasture and grazing land, you can also include the next very important one, that is land under miscellaneous tree crops, hai na? Land under miscellaneous tree crops. Land under miscellaneous tree crops. So suppose if this is coming under the you have grown a tree, so in that particular area now you cannot do the cultivation. Similarly, if it is used for the pasture or the grazing purpose by the animals, then also in that place you cannot do the cultivation, hai na? So permanent pasture and grazing land and land under miscellaneous tree crops can be the best example here. Now the third one is cultivable wasteland, hai na? Cultivable wastelands. So here, what is the cultivable wasteland? The land which is left for more than 5 years without doing cultivation. Once again, I'm repeating, cultivable wasteland is the land which is left uncultivated for more than 5 years. Then it will be called as cultivable wasteland. Here you are not including the empty lands, na? You are not including the fallow lands. So fallow lands or the empty lands we are not using here. That we will use separately in the fourth point. The fourth point we will have, that is fallow land. So what is fallow lands? So fallow lands are the empty land, that is not, we are not doing agriculture here in this fallow land. So this fallow land further you can classify into two parts. That the first one is current fallow land, and the second one is other than current fallow land, hai na? Other than current fallow land. Okay, other than current fallow land. So what is the meaning of current fallow land? So in current fallow land, you are not using the land for cultivation for 1 year or less than 1 year, hai na? So here land is uncultivated for less than 1 year. Okay, 1 year or less than 1 year. Less than 1 year. One agricultural year it will be. Fine. Now other than current fallow land, so here land will be uncultivated uncultivated for more than 1 year and less than 5 years, है ना? So one to five agricultural year. Agricultural year, है ना? So what is the difference here? Current fallow land, you are not doing cultivation on a land for less than 1 year, okay, or 1 year. And here, other than current fallow land means you are not using the land for cultivation more than 1 year to 5 year, है ना? 1 to 5 year, okay. So more than 1 year and less than 5 year. And suppose if it is going more than 5 year, then it will be called as culturable wasteland. So here it is more than 5 year. Here I am writing uncultivated for more than 5 years. For more than 5 years. Okay, 5 years or more than 5 years, then it will be called as culturable wasteland. Fine. I hope till here picture is clear to all of you. Now the last one is the fifth point I just want to tell you. Very, very important concept this is. That is known as, here I'm writing here, fifth point. So in fifth point, two particular thing I just want to tell you. That first one is net zone area, and the second one is gross cropped area, hai na? Gross cropped area. Okay, the first one is net zone area and the second one is gross cropped area. So for understanding this net zone area and gross cropped area, I'll make one diagram here, so you can also make diagram in your copy. So suppose this is the piece of land you have and the size of the land is 10 acre, hai na? This is the agricultural land and the size of the land is 10 acre. What is acre? Acre is the measurement of land. Acre is the standard unit of measurement of land, that is acre. Fine. So here suppose you have 10 acre of land. So what is the meaning of net zone area? So net zone area is the total area under cultivation. What is the meaning net zone area? Total area under cultivation. And this net zone area is counted only one time, hai na? We count net zone area only one time. So suppose If you are using the complete 10 acre area for the cultivation, so your net zone area will be 10 acre, hai na? What will be your net zone area? It will be 10 acre. Okay, it will be 10 acre. So then what is the gross cropped area? So gross cropped area is similar to net zone area, but here gross cropped area, na, you are counting multiple times. For example, suppose in 1 year, I am using this land for 3 times, hai na? In 1 year, I am using this agricultural land for 3 times. So what will be the gross cropped area? Gross cropped area will be counted 3 times. So 10 acre one time, 10 acre second time, 10 acre third time. So the total gross cropped area will be 30 acre. Understood? So what is the difference here? Net zone area and gross cropped area are both similar, but net zone area is counted only one time and gross cropped area is counted multiple times, hai na? So I hope this net zone area and gross cropped area is clear to all of you. So in this way, the use of land is clear to all of you. Now the next very important part is land degradation and conservation method of land, hai na? Land degradation, and what are the solution for this land degradation, that also we will see. So first of all, let's rub the board and then we will start that.